we just look at the extremes that we're experiencing with weather and climate, think of wind storms, droughts, heat waves, and these extremes will change with climate change as well. If you just look at the last 20 years, the economic impact of these extremes have been tremendous. For example, the economic loss has been over $3 trillion, actually. There's been more than 1.3 million fatalities because of natural hazards. So it's obvious that natural hazards and extremes are really, really important for everybody's life.
Weather and climate models help to improve our understanding of the seemingly chaotic processes that occur in the Earth's weather and climate system. Both weather forecasts and climate projections can prepare us for possible future developments. In any case, powerful supercomputers are needed.
The European Union funds a number of centers of excellence to provide supercomputing applications. Climate and weather models always have been one of the most important applications for supercomputers. Climate and weather modeling is impossible without having access to the largest computers in the world.
The Center of Excellence for Simulation of Weather and Climate in Europe, or ESiWACE, helps to adapt the weather and climate models to the latest state-of-the-art supercomputers, so that the simulations can reproduce even small-scale processes in great detail.
So we have to do our level best to predict some possible future scenarios. And then we have to weigh the decisions we make, whether it be build a new building, build a new dam. Those decisions have to be made with our best knowledge of what could happen. Our best knowledge of what could happen is produced by simulations at the highest possible resolution using the most complex models and our best physical understanding. To do that, we need new models running on new computers, and otherwise we're stuck with the knowledge we have now, and the knowledge we have now is not good enough.
We are already living in a climate which is changing, and it is going to further increase in the future. To help prepare for this change, we need to have climate models that allow us to inform in advance of what are the impacts or what are the changes we can expect. So to prepare to adapt to climate change, it's important to have the best information. So to have the models with the highest resolution, to be the more efficient on computers is a tool which more and more help us to adapt, because we have to adapt to climate change.
And what we've been doing for the past 40 years in climate research has been marching through the desert as we've made scales finer and finer, but never really reached the scales that matter most. And we're now right at this threshold, right at this edge, where with a little bit more push, we can simulate scales of motion that we never could simulate before, and which are crucially important to how the climate system evolves.
Some 25 to 30 years ago, only simulations with grid spacings of about 500 kilometers were possible. Until today, the grid spacing could, although only for selected short calculations, gradually be reduced to 2.5 kilometers. But the aim of ESiWACE is far more ambitious, a snap change in the quality of weather and climate simulations.
A lot of the additional warming that we fear is due to low clouds going away slowly. And if they go away a little less slowly, or maybe don't go away at all, then the warming won't be as strong as some of the worst scenarios predict. It doesn't mean, of course, that we don't have to worry about it, but maybe we have a bit more time to worry about it than our biggest fears. So it will give us a new ability to look at how clouds are changing in climate.
Reducing the uncertainty in weather and climate simulations calls, in particular, for a better understanding of clouds and precipitation. To achieve this, those factors need to be calculated explicitly, instead of just being approximated. This in turn means that the grid spacing must be significantly reduced, down to about 1 kilometer.
We have not enough scientific evidence to actually say that models that will have very high resolution will inevitably produce predictive skill, because we can't run them right now. But it's obvious, and it's our expectation, that this is going to happen, because we know the equations of motion in the atmosphere. We know they are exact, actually. And we know if we will describe smaller scale processes, the physics that we present in our models is more realistic. There's no way around it.
The beautiful thing about Europe, and I say this as an American, is Europeans do know how to cooperate. They do know how to work together. And through the European projects, like ESiWACE, it brings together an enormous amount of talent from different countries to focus on big goals. And ESiWACE is something that enables, across Europe, people to come together to really push the frontier at the very edge of the science to compete with very large countries like China or the United States.
ESiWACE is concentrating the expertise on a European level, thereby helping to facilitate efficient simulations with the new weather and climate models that are needed from a scientific point of view on the computer systems of tomorrow.
Software for simulating climate or weather is developed by very large teams of people across Europe. That software is bespoke, made individually at every large organization. So for example, in Germany, there are at least two centers that are doing fantastic jobs building software, similarly in the UK and France. But each of our individual group has got to the state where now we can't do it alone. The task is too big. We have to work together. And ESiWACE is a project that pools the might of Europe to bring together the software that we need to get to the future.
In that respect, ESiWACE Center of Excellence is quite important for us. It's an essential part of the overall project because it helps prepare us for future computer generation, future models.
Europe wants to be one of the world leaders in supercomputing. Europe wants to build its own supercomputer. Europe wants to build one of the first exascale supercomputers in the world. For these supercomputers, you need applications. And Europe is already world leading in climate and weather modeling. So climate and weather models are supercomputing applications which have a long history in Europe.
ATOS is committed to providing HPC solutions to national weather services and climate research centers. Météo France, KNMI, DKRZ have chosen our Bull Sequana supercomputers, the only supercomputers designed and assembled in Europe. Along the years, we have developed a recognized expertise in designing and supporting large-scale production-grade environments to the weather and climate community. To ensure the success of our future European technology, it is compulsory to bring together technology and application experts, and in particular, experts in weather forecast and climate domain.
With this new generation of models, it allows us to simulate scales, which gets this other part of the problem. So we can solve both of the two essential parts of the climate problem, which is how energy gets from the surface near the equator into the atmosphere, and then how that energy gets transported to the poles. So fundamentally, it gives us a much more physics-based way to simulate the climate system.
Centers such as the European Center for Medium Range Weather Forecasts, ECMWF, and the German Climate Computing Center, DKRZ, are making a key contribution to this. With the Mistral computer at the DKRZ, for example, simulations with a cloud-resolving model for Germany, consisting of 25 billion grid cells, can be carried out. The resulting volume of data comes to many petabytes. A sophisticated data management system stores this data, allowing it to be reused and reanalyzed. ESiWACE supports innovative ways of analyzing and visualizing the enormous amounts of data generated during these simulations.
We will produce more data inevitably, and it will be harder and harder to actually extract the relevant information from this vast amount of data. And so, just like we deal with computing problems in ESiWACE, we also deal with the information problem. How do we actually extract the relevant information from the exabytes of original data that we produce?
Studying the climate and drawing the right conclusions from the results of this research is a global task. The European project ESiWACE is an important step towards tackling these challenges, because complex tasks can only be solved together. ESiWACE is supporting Europe in developing the best applications for the fastest supercomputers.